Well, hello guys. Welcome to the Dundas Junction Model Railroad. I think this is going to call this update number 2. Since my last video, I have made some progress on the train room. I have finished the walls and the one half in the previous video, and I started to get the other side ready for the next phase of the construction. I'm going to do a tour of the new space with some other information that we have. I know my space for this new train room that I'm working on is approximately 21 feet by 13 feet. But I do have some obstacles that I need to deal with and trying to work the track around these two obstacles, one being the furnace and hot water tank, and there's a bump out in the one corner in front of the house that is altering to a normal track plan. But we're working on the idea of a double bent dog bone layout, that you call it, or a bent dog bone layout. So I've unpacked a lot of stuff to see what I'm missing. There's still more to go, but we will I'll do a tour with my cell phone, and I'll link them all together. I have a couple of short clips of the space after I finished installing the plywood and after I primed the plywood. Then I filled it in. And the idea is get the other half empty so I can get that ready to go for the next phase. Hopefully next year we'll start working on bench work. So I'm going to pause this for a bit, and we'll come back with another clip, and we'll chat soon, guys. Thanks very much. Okay guys, so this is the rear wall of the train room, and this is the part that I was working on last in the last update, and I finished the walls and I painted it, and I've unboxed a lot of the trains, and I've also moved all the boxes I had on one side. We're now up in this side of the room. Now I created a temporary workbench so I can work on stuff. So you can see, unpacking a few things up on the shelf there. Now this space is totally empty. Well, as total as I can make it. So this is the bump out that I have to deal with here. It's approximately 4 feet by about 3 feet. So we have to adjust the track to get around that obstacle. But I'm also going to frame in this little alcove up here. And I'm going to incorporate into my tracks plan somehow. I could have a spur line going up in there, some small industry, but we're going to put it to use. Every square inch is valuable real estate for a railroad. But that's the next step, is I got to frame this all in and insulate it. Now I had to move the water line to suit trains. So here's the, this section here I'm standing, this is 13 feet wide from that wall to the wall behind me. And it veers over to here. There's the hot water tank and the fern. So I do have space underneath the water tank that I can work a track plan into, a track into that area, or access to a layout. So I'm hoping to incorporate that space as much as I can. And up here is the doorway to the other part of the house. I'm hoping to have a peninsula somewhere in this area here where the workbench is. But
I have made major progress, that's for sure. And I'm going to go through some of my stuff tomorrow night on my live stream. But yeah, it is a challenging times, but I hope to find more stuff and think unpack things, because I'm missing a few things. But that is the space that I have. So from that end there, from the stud wall to where my light switch is, that is 21 feet in length of space. I can't go any further because the bathroom's next door. And I don't want to take up the hallway space. But that's, I think it's going to work out. I have lots of track ideas. I'm going to try and do a track update and post a clip to it with this video showing a few ideas. But I'm not sure if I'll be able to get it done, but I'm going to try. But that is it, guys. As I said before, I have a couple little clips showing this space here with it emptied and just putting the plywood up. And you can visualize what I have to work with. But we'll call this update number 2. Okay, guys. That's all for a bit. Thanks, guys.